Welcome to the Chalk Club. My name is Beth Stamp. I am an independent designer with Chalk Couture, and we are going to do a ink project. We're going to make a t-shirt today. So let me get my iPad set up so I can see comments. If you're here, say hi. Tell me you're watching. Where are you watching from? Is it pouring rain where you live like it is where I live? We got about 2 inches of snow last night, and now it's mostly melted because it's snowing. Or, excuse me, it's raining. Oh, goodness. Always something, right? Always something. Let's see if we can see what's happening. Here we go. All right. I'll turn volume all the way off, and then I can see what is happening with my comments. Maybe. Kind of, sort of. Hey, Kelly. I'm glad you're here. Boaz, yes, rain for days. Oh, gosh. Oh, goodness. That is no good. Okay. So we are going to be doing ink on black t-shirt. So I just have a plain black t-shirt. This is going to be for my daughter. And we're going to, once it's all done, I'm going to cut the neck out of it, and then we're going to tie it up on the side. She's not here to model it. Goodness gracious. Else today, isn't it? See if we can make that better. Okay. Good. Okay, so first thing we need to do is we need our sticky mat. So these are, they're one-sided mats that are sticky, and you place them inside your ink projects, and it helps hold the t-shirt in place while we're working on it. So we just put that in there. This is a new mat. Gotta love the new mats because they stick so good. They make me happy. Okay, so we just place the t-shirt, place it right in there. When you're using a lighter colored shirt, and even with the dark colored ones, I would still use an ink mat. I guess you could not use it if you didn't want to, but there is the potential that the ink could bleed through. So you don't want that. That's no good. That is no good. Okay, so let's do this. I'm just pulling the t-shirt tight so we don't have any weird wrinkles. And here's the transfer we're going to do. It says, kindness changes everything. This is one of the brand new transfers that just came out last week with our new catalog. If you've not seen our new catalog yet and you want to see it, comment catalog and I will send you my link to the catalog where you can watch a little video demo of the catalog because it's pretty freaking incredible, if I do say so myself. So I'm just going to place this right down. I am not fuzzing this. For those of you who watch my other chalk projects, you would know I fuzz the transfer first, especially with a new one. When I do t-shirts or other textiles, I don't fuzz it because I want it to be really sticky on whatever surface I'm doing. And I'm just using my squeegee. Push all the little air bubbles out. I want it to be super tight against the t-shirt so we don't get any bleeding. This is a reusable silk screen transfer. And that's how we can get all of this awesome detail. There's my t-shirt. Sort of kind of centered. Good enough for what I do. I don't do perfect. If you are a perfect crafter, kudos, I am not one. Okay, so here's what we're doing. We are going to use white ink. Let's see if I can get that to like not have such terrible glare. And then we're also going to use shimmer silver. And what I'm thinking I'm going to do is do the shimmer silver in the fancy lettering and then do the white in the middle. So let's do the silver first. So ink is very different from chalk. If you've seen me work with chalk, ink does not dry nearly as quickly as chalk does. So you have a little bit more time to work with it, which I like. I'm just gently stirring this, and a little bit of ink goes a long way. So I'm going to take just a little dab, and I'm going to put it right on. And ink is not removable, so it goes where it goes, so you have to be careful. Take your time when you're doing this. Make a little oopsie. Then there are ways to hide oopsies with other transfers. gotta get a little creative, but it can be done. I've done it. Let's try not to get ink on my shirt. And what I'm doing right now is I'm taking my time and I'm really working this through the silk screen, because the shimmer, you want to just make sure it pushes all the way through. And I want, on a dark shirt with these light colors, I'm actually going to apply the ink a little bit thicker than I normally would, because I really want it to pop. Just put that right on. How many of you have seen me live before? You put a number one in the comments if you've never seen me live, and a number two in the comments if you have. And if you are a member of my team, put a number three. Then I know who's here. I can say hey to you. All right, so that's the top. And now I'm gonna go ahead and do the bottom. And then we'll do the white. These are, t-shirts are super easy. You can get these, I call them one and done transfers, even though we're using two colors, because they are quick and easy. You can blow dry these designs after you've peeled up your transfer and then heat set it. That's the thing with ink. If you want it to be permanent, you need to heat set it. And you can use an iron, or you can use an easy press. Whatever you have will work. We're just making sure we get lots of ink on this so it stays pretty. Squeegee on, squeegee off. I missed your comment. Okay, let's see. Watching from Philadelphia. Oh, the volume is too low. Oh, it's on your phone, Linda. Oh, or Lindy. Okay, good, because I don't know how to fix the volume on my end. That would be no good. Let's find a paper towel here. What do you guys think of my new setup? Very different from when we were in the apartment. Similar in ways, but also very different, because we're at a standing desk now, which is so much better for me because I am 5'11", and it's hard to lean over on the desk. So this is bright white ink again. Oh, terrible, terrible lighting today, guys. That's okay. I'll link all the products that I'm using today once I'm done. If you are interested in trying a project, you can put the word project in the comments, and I have some little, what I call like beginner projects that are super easy, they're small, they're inexpensive, and it's a really nice way to try. I do recommend that when you're first starting, you try chalk, because it is removable. And the surface that I send you is reusable, so it's just a nice way to practice. Let's see. I will check comments here in a second. Trying not to get silver where the white is. Make sure that I get lots of white paste. Because like I said, black shirt, white paste, you want to make sure you get a lot. Now, if you guys saw the video I did the other day where I fixed my little oopsie, you can go back and look for that. So it'll show you what'll happen if you don't get enough paste or ink on a project. It is fixable. Okay. Let me lift this up. I'm gonna show it to you. Get all the ink off my fingers first. So here's our t-shirt. Here's our t-shirt with, you can get the, now we will peel and reveal. Okay, so I like to try to peel it from the center and not just one corner. And because you have to treat your transfers more like they're a fabric than they are a piece of vinyl, because they're not vinyl. So there's the transfer. After we're done with it, you can see through it. And we'll wash that. We can reuse this 8 to 12 times when we take good care of it. Let's see how our t-shirt turned out. What do we think? Cute, right? Look at all that detail. Look how cute you can do these t-shirts. I love these. I love it, love it, love it. All right, so quick and easy, guys. I told you it was going to be quick today. I will be back on Wednesday, and we're going to do a a little bit more of a complex project, which will be fun. I have another new transfer that I got that is super cute. I may tease it for you guys here so you can see. But if you have questions, please put them in the comments. Otherwise, have a fantastic day, and I will see you all later.